happened was the whole southern state has had 7-8 days of just ferocious winds. Not one day, not two, not three, not four, but it's been 7 days. We've got a lull right now, and we've got more winds coming this weekend. So been very ferocious. Not so much where I am. I'm in the northwest of the state, but the southern area, well, yeah, they really got some strong winds. 140, 150 kilometres an hour, so all along the southern coastline going up into New South Wales. So consequently, I would imagine that a lot of hams woke up to antennas down, towers down, what have you. It's pretty hard to withstand that. I know we had 80 kilometre an hour winds up here, which is equivalent to about 50 miles an hour, and boy, it blew a gale. Thankfully, other than my cubicle quad having a little bit of slippage, there was no other damage done. So, yeah, it's been quite ferocious, and there's more to come, John, over. No, it's not normal, to be fair, John, it is not normal. We typically get windy conditions for days in late October, a month after the equinox, but not this time of year. So October is typically the windy month, so we're a little bit early, and they talked about equivalent to cyclonic level 3 winds, and this is the first time in, I think they said, 70 or 80 years we've experienced wind conditions such as this. And of course, you know, roofs have been destroyed, the garages have gone, you know, if trampolines are not tied down, they've gone through the air. And of course, all this flying debris, particularly in the suburban area, because Melbourne got it really bad, it becomes dangerous. It just basically becomes dangerous. And a few people, unfortunately, have lost their lives, mainly due to trees falling on their house or trees falling on their motor vehicle. So yeah, it's been pretty severe, I can tell you. Anyway, let me pass back up to Steve, M0EBJ in the group, VK3CWB.